Hi guys, welcome to the Sanctuary Altar. My name is Diana Rina, wherever you're listening from. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Happy new month of November. We are going to start our Bible study. Today is 1st November. We need to thank the Lord for the gift of life that He has given us. We do not take it for granted. So many people have not made it this far. We have only 1 month to go. Until the end of 2023, we're going into the new year, the year of 2024, the year of elevation, the year of blessings, the year that the Lord is going to turn around everything, the year of quickening. Yeah, the heavens are going to open for us, the floodgates of heaven are going to open for us, the Lord is going to fight our battles, the Lord is going to make us victorious. The year is here. So, yeah, wherever you're listening from, once again, good morning. If you're on your way to work, you're stuck in traffic, you are just getting out to go to work, you're preparing yourself to get out and go to work, you work from home, and yeah, wherever you're listening from, I hope this Bible study or this month blesses you and you experience the elevation. Don't miss out. Be open to receive. I told you, have an open spirit, have a big heart, ask the Lord to expand your spirit, ask the Lord to expand your boundaries, do not limit God, just pray open prayers within the word and be ready to receive. Do not tell the Lord what to do, just go and pray open prayers, be ready to receive your blessing of elevation this month. So without saying much, our reading is coming from the book of Psalm, chapter 75, verse 7 to 8. Basically, this psalm is about thanksgiving for God's righteous judgment. Thanksgiving for God's righteous judgment. So the Lord is finally serving justice. The Lord has stood up. The Lord has gotten up to rain His wrath on the sinner. Yeah, the Lord is making us victors over the unrighteous. Yeah. The Lord is finally passing judgment. Yeah. The Lord is passing judgment for our sake. So it says, we are in 75, Psalm chapter 75, verse 7 to 8. It says, but God is the judge. He puts down one and exalts another. But God is the judge. He puts down one and exalts another. For in the hand of the Lord there is a cup, and the wine is red. It is fully mixed, and He pours it out. Surely its dregs shall all the wicked of the earth drain and drink down. So basically, this chapter is self-explanatory, but you have to have revelation. You have to have the spirit of discernment, knowledge, and understanding for you to get the revelation within the word that you're reading, no matter how easy it is. So it's basically saying that God is the final judge of everything. He puts down one and exalts another. He's putting down the unrighteous to exalt the righteous. Yeah, He's putting down the unrighteous to exalt the righteous. So He is putting down one and He's exalting another. The one He's putting down is the unrighteous, yeah? And the one He is uplifting is the righteous. For in the hands of the Lord there is a cup, yeah? And the wine is red, yeah? That wine in the cup is God's wrath, yeah? It is fully mixed and He pours it out. That is the wrath of God. The red wine in the cup that He pours out is the wrath of God. Yeah, He pours it out. Surely its dregs shall all the wicked of the earth drain and drink down. Yeah, dregs. Yeah, there is that word that says, surely its dregs shall all the wicked of the earth drain and drink down. Dregs. What is dregs? So What are dregs? It's basically remnants of a liquid, the most worthless part of something. Yeah, that is what dregs means, the most worthless part of something. Yeah, these are remnants of a liquid, and it is the most worthless part of something, because he says he pours it out. Yeah, that is his wrath. Surely its dregs shall all wicked of the earth drain and drink down. Yeah, they will drink down up to the most worthless part of that wine. Yeah, they will drink up to the most worthless part of that wine. Yeah, so basically the Lord is judging the sinners. The Lord is lifting us up. Yeah, give your life to Christ. Yeah, accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. Yeah, so that he can lift you up, so that he can elevate you. Yeah, accept him in your life, become righteous. Yeah, become righteous, have the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Yeah, walk in the Lord, accept him, acknowledge him as your personal Lord and Savior, so that he can elevate you. Yeah, so that he can elevate you, because he said he will put down one and exalt another. That means he will put down the unrighteous and exalt the righteous. Yeah, so you need to be righteous. You need to walk in God's ways. Learn how to repent. When you sin, there is always room for repentance. Yeah, we commit sins knowingly and unknowingly, but the Lord wants to judge. Yeah, the Lord wants to pass his wrath. The Lord has finally lifted from his throne. He is coming down to judge the unrighteous on your behalf. He's coming to put down your enemy on your behalf. Finally, the judgment you've been praying for, the prayers you've been praying for, asking the Lord to rise up for you, he's here this November to do it for you. All you have to do is walk in his ways. Accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. Be righteous, be cautious, yeah? Learn the ways of the Lord, make him your friend, yeah? Have a personal relationship with God, yeah? Accept his salvation in your life, yeah? Because once again he has said, but God is the judge. You have been praying. Judgment is for the Lord. The Lord has finally heard. He has heard, yeah? He is ready to put down one, that is your enemy, and exalt another, that is you. For in the hand of the Lord there is a cup, and the wine is red. Yeah, he's finally going to rain his wrath. He's going to rain his wrath. But in order for it to work for you, he must find you spotless. Yeah, Jesus died for our sins. He shed his blood for our sins, and that made us spotless. We are worthy in the eyes of God. He must find you worthy, yeah, so that his wrath can work in your favor. Yeah, it is fully mixed and he pours it out. Yeah, the wine, he pours out the wine. Surely it's dregs. Yeah, the most worthless part of something. I told you that is what dregs mean. Shall all the wicked of the earth drain and drink down. Don't be part of the wicked. Let the Lord not find you part of the wicked. Yeah, let the Lord not find you part of the wicked. Salvation is here. Open your eyes. Accept him. Get born again. Get saved, you know. Accept him once again. Open your mouth and pronounce his name as your personal Lord and Savior. So, in conclusion, this verse is God judging our enemies. Is God uplifting us over above. Yeah, exalting us above our enemies. Those are the unrighteous. What has been troubling you? Who has been troubling you for a long time? His wrath is here to help you. He wants to exalt you. He wants to lift you above your enemies. Yeah, he wants to lift you above your enemies. If you're listening to this message, it is for you. The month of November, the Lord is uplifting us. Let us be righteous. Let us give our lives to Christ. Let's ask him to cleanse our hearts, so that when his wrath comes, it finds us righteous. Yeah, it finds us righteous, and it uplifts us. It elevates us. It puts us in higher positions. It finds us in higher positions. So this morning the prayer will be, Dear Lord, thank you so much for today's word. Thank you so much for everything that you do for us, Heavenly Father. We ask of you, Lord, that you cleanse us with your blood. We are here to repent, Heavenly Father. Forgive us for the sins that we've committed knowingly and unknowingly, Heavenly Father. Forgive us, Lord, where we have wronged you, Lord Jesus Christ. Cleanse us with your blood, Heavenly Father. We need you in our lives, Heavenly Father. Make us righteous, Heavenly Father. We need you, Lord Jesus. We are nothing without you, Heavenly Father. We pray that, Lord, may your wrath reign, Heavenly Father. May your wrath reign, Heavenly Father, and exalt us, Heavenly Father. Put down our enemies, Heavenly Father, so that we can be exalted, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus. Because your word says, Heavenly Father, according to chapter 75, verse 7 to 8, Heavenly Father, your word says that you are the judge, Heavenly Father. You say that you will put down one and exalt another, Heavenly Father. May I be the one that you exalt, Heavenly Father. I ask for your mercy, Heavenly Father, so that when your cup runs over, Heavenly Father, mixed with red wine, Heavenly Father, it pours out, Heavenly Father, and it finds me among the righteous, Heavenly Father. In the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, its dregs shall all the wicked of the earth drain and drink down, Heavenly Father. In the name of Jesus, thank you so much, Lord. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your righteous judgment. Thank you for lifting up for me, Heavenly Father. Thank you for raining your wrath, Heavenly Father. I thank you for coming through for me, Heavenly Father. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord. Lord, I do not take your help for granted. In the same light, Heavenly Father, we ask that you grant us the spirit of knowledge, the spirit of understanding, and the spirit of wisdom, Heavenly Father, and the spirit of discernment, so that we are able to apply your word in our day-to-day lives. In the name of Jesus, I have believed and prayed. Amen. God bless you. May he exalt you. May he lift you up. May he put down one and lift you up. May he put down the unrighteous and lift you up. For your favor, in the name of Jesus, you are worthy in the eyes of God. The month of November, the theme is elevation. The Lord is going to elevate us. He's going to uplift you and put you in better positions because you deserve it. You have been righteous. God bless you. Bye.